Guys, Tuckett here, and what I've done is I've gone through every single skill gem in the game, and I've made a list of abilities that I can highly recommend for League starting in Delirium. I've got 26 abilities, so I haven't prepared party buildings for each one. Instead, I'll go through each ability, pick why I picked it, what it'll be good for, and then I'll show you how to find the builds on PB Ninja. And for anyone who's like, I don't know what I'm going to be League starting the new Diablo season, check out Diablo fans. Don't do that, it's a shit game. Anyway. Let's talk about what we've picked. Now, again, massive disclaimer, because there's going to be some people who still don't get the point of this video. These are all abilities that I can recommend as League start options that will feel good for the Delirium mechanic. These are not the only good starter builds. There are good starter builds I haven't mentioned. There are plenty of very strong starter builds that will feel good for the mechanic with a little bit of gear, but I have only included skills that feel amazing from day one. Okay, so for melee, Cyclone. Cyclone's always great. You can go Cyclone, Facebreaker, Impale Champion and have ridiculous damage with incredibly low investment. Would recommend. Lacerate. Lacerate, you go Glad, Bleed Explosions. Steel's considering it for his League start, so if you wanted a build for that, check out Steel. Very solid clear, good single target, just feels great with nothing. Bladestorm, exact same reasoning as Lacerate. You just do the exact same build, but using Bladestorm instead of Lacerate. Earthquake. Earthquake is actually going to be pretty good for this League mechanic, I think, because it's just a case of you just hit the ground, run, hit the ground, run. A big thing about chasing the Delirium Fog will be having builds which map with momentum, while Earthquake will feel very, very good. And again, in case you didn't know, Delirium encounters are timed. Delirium orbs mean that you use on maps won't be timed. Delirium maps are timed. Only ones that you put orbs on aren't timed. So I've still seen a lot of confusion about that. And if you still don't know how it works, I made a video yesterday explaining how Delirium Fog works. Sunder. Same thought process as Bladestorm and Lacerate. It's just a very good skill. Get a bunch of attack speed. Jump around. Easy as. Dot abilities. I will be doing a League start video in a lot of depth, all to do with Chaos Dots. So if you'll be playing that, I will have a dedicated video on that for you. And that will be in my League start personally. Corsica. Corsica is one of my favorite abilities. It's very easy to League start with. You can use it from level 2 with 0 gear. Once you get a 3-link bow, you're set, and that will take you all the way. It also combos very nicely with Toxic Rain if you're low on single target. And yeah, it will just feel very good for the League mechanic. Can definitely recommend. Puncture / Rain of Irish to Split Arrow. Now, this is slightly cheating because this is something that you would League start as one of these melee abilities, then you'd swap into it. But yeah, you go Glad, you go Bleed, you use bows. Very good clear, very good single target. Again, Steel was picking between going for a Puncture Bleed or a Lacerate Bleed setup. So look at him for setups. Toxic Rain. Exact same setup as Corsica. Some people prefer the playstyle of Toxic Rain. Some people prefer the playstyle of Corsica. Some people use both. I personally prefer the playstyle of Corsica, but Toxic Rain will feel very good. You can also use it in mines. But great single target. Decent clear. Would recommend. Bane. Bane Pop Occultist is very popular. And will get you to maps incredibly quickly. Also, if you're playing an Essence Rain Contagion build, I'd actually recommend leveling with Bane once you get it in Act 3. The one issue you might have with Bane is it has the lowest dot damage of any of the Chaos dots. So you're gonna want to combo it with like Bane plus Essence Rain plus Blight. I think Delirium might be very rippy, so I think if you are going for a Chaos caster, try to combo abilities so you don't have to Blight too hard. I think Blight might actually really struggle because you'll just get like one shot. Vortex / Cold Snap. Vortex / Cold Snap is a very solid damage over time starter. Rory's actually going to be playing that as his League starter if you watch the developer bake off a couple of days ago. It's always very strong as a League start. You can do it as a cultist or trickster. I would personally play it probably as a trickster. If you want to go low life eventually, play it as a cultist. Would recommend. ED Contagion feels great. I would always go ED Contagion on Trickster over a Cultist, but you can do that if you'd like. Ignite Fireball. Ignite Fireball is very zoom. It's actually like very much slept on as a good starter build. And you can also transition it into a lot of other builds if you wanted to mess around with other damage over time builds. Some people do like Ignite Fireball, then go into like Righteous Fire to speed clear maps later on. But yeah, Ignite Fireball would always recommend as a Trickster. Solrend. Solrend, I would play that as a trickster. Solrend is one of those abilities where you would start as Bane and then you'd swap into Solrend. Once you've got the cast you're going, once you've got the links, once you've got the GMP, it maps really smooth, really, really smooth. And it does have higher single target damage than Bane. So if you're someone who doesn't like juggling lots of different spells, Solrend is very good of like, I'm the guy who just presses one Chaos button It feels great. Self-cast. I've got a couple of self-cast builds. Blade Vortex. Bladefall, Blade Blast, all of that stuff. We don't know how good it will feel. We know Blade Vortex feels good. And if you want to mess around with Blade Blast, if you play a Blade Vortex build and it's good, great. You can then mess around with Blade Blast. Maybe it becomes even better. But would definitely recommend Blade Vortex. Frostbolt slash Ice Nova. Frostbolt slash Ice Nova is very good. Requires very little gear. You can scale it pretty hard with investment. Yeah, just should be solid. Orb of Storms. Orb of Storms, people have been using it to cheese leveling for ages. You can have it as your early start and then transition to something else. Yeah, Orb of Storms will be good. Magma Orb. So you can get a Star of Shards very early. It's very cheap, unique. You get it on like day one. Magma Orb is also an ability which always has had ridiculous amounts of single target damage when you go into stuff like Gloom Fang, Stacking Chains, all this other stuff. You could do like Magma Orb, Star of Shards, then Weapon Swap into a DPS star for single target. Magma Orb will feel very, very good. Without any gear, early leveling might feel a bit rough, so maybe you do like Fireball to level, swap into Magma Orb. Once you got the setup, it will like fly. It'll be great. Stormbrand. You could also go Armageddon Brand, but Armageddon Brand kind of falls off. Stormbrand doesn't. Stormbrand, great map clear. Seems kind of interesting with some of the new Archmage supports. Loads of different ascendancy options. Yeah, Stormbrand's pretty good. Totems. Again, there are lots of good totem builds. These are just the two that stand out the most to me for being good for Delirium as a mechanic. Arc Totems and Freeze Pulse Totems. Both of them are solid. That's really all I have to say about it. And again, you could transition them into any other totem build. Maybe with gear, you then transition to like Divine Eye Totems or something kind of like that. For Mines. For Mines, Arc Mines for Clear. You could use Ball Lightning Mines for single target, but you definitely are using Arc Mines for Clear. Icicle Mine. Icicle Mine still feels pretty good. You just need a bit of projectile speed investment on it. Toxic Drain Mines. Toxic Drain Mines, as you mentioned, very good ability. Traps. I would probably only really play Lightning Trap. From what we've seen in the mechanic, you want something which has got decent coverage. Fire Trap, Explosive Trap, they're great. Explosive Trap especially is amazing with a bit of investment in it. But it's one of those things early on, you might not have enough AoE. It might feel a bit rough. I'd say go Lightning Trap, and then if you want to, you could then swap into something like an Explosive Trap later on. Minions. Animate Weapon looks like it will be good. The thing which is nice about Animate Weapon is they have a very long duration. So what you could do is, before you activate the mirror, is you drop a bunch of blades, summon your maximum stack of Animate Weapons. Once you've got everything up, you then activate the encounter, and you're at full momentum. Any build which can get to full momentum before the event starts will be solid. I can also very much see like a Zumi Spectre build using Skellies for single target. Spectre's got hit pretty hard, but I'm sure there'll still be a good, just a map clear Spectre option. And Skellies still do ridiculous damage and will be very solid for just single target. I will leave a link to this document down below. And yeah, those are all abilities I would recommend. They're not the only good abilities, they're just the ones that I would recommend. So, let's say like, okay, that's great, Tarki, but I don't have any path of buildings, so how am I meant to pick my league start? All I know is like, whatever. So what I'd say is, I would pick one of these archetypes. So let's say you were interested by the totem thing. You're like, oh, the totem thing sounded kind of cool. Go onto Metamorph, and depending on what league you're looking in, look in either Metamorph, Hardcore Metamorph, or SSF. And then just kind of search for, okay, we'll look for arc totems. So we'll look for people who went Hierophant. And we'll look at people who went Freeze Pulse. We've got people who went arc. And just kind of look at their links, look at how they did their trees. You can show the passive heat map. And just get some core ideas, right? You can also, once you've picked a build, you could then search specifically for the build you want. There are plenty of other content creators making dedicated guides. Mathel always makes a list of like 10 videos. But yeah, that's kind of how you go about that. So just use Pew Ninja, use the resources available to you. Would highly recommend going through this, but yes. I'm Tarki. Have a good day. Don't play Diablo 3, by the way. Bye-bye.